Okay, now we have our next topic about the deficiency diseases. So what are the deficiency diseases? As I have already told you about the balanced diet, if any component is missing in the balanced diet, then it will cause the deficiency in our body. If the component is missing and deficiency occur, then it will cause the diseases. And that type of diseases which is caused by the deficiency of any substance or any component of the food, that is called as the deficiency diseases. And on the other hand, if you get the excess amount of the any component, for example, if you have taken lot amount of burger, pizza or noodles, okay, if you taken a large quantity of all these types of the component of the food, then all these contain fats. Okay, so if you taken the excess intake of the food, it will cause the overeating and it will leads to the obesity. That is the obesity. Okay, means your stomach is bulges out. Okay, so the deficiency or excess amount of any component of the food is also very harmful for our body, and it will cause various types of the diseases. Okay, yes, let's start with the first component, that is the carbohydrate. So if we have a deficiency of carbohydrate, it means we can't get energy, because carbohydrate is a main source of the energy. If there is a deficiency of the carbohydrates, it means we can't get the energy, so we feel very tired, our body become weak, our stamina become weak. So these are the common deficiency syndromes of the carbohydrates. Okay, next we have deficiency of the protein. So protein is a bodybuilding food, so if you have the deficiency of the protein, then it will leads to the stunted growth. Stunted growth means your growth become reduced or your growth become very less. Okay, then we have a swelling of the face, then we have diarrhea. Diarrhea means loss of the water from the body. Next we have discoloration of the hair. Your hair color will be changed, you can get a skin problem also, and your abdomen will also swollen. So these are the deficiency syndromes in case of the if you have the deficiency of the protein. Okay, next we have the some two main diseases which occur due to the deficiency of the protein. So first we have kwashiorkor, second we have marasmus. So kwashiorkor is a disease which occur in the children due to the deficiency of the protein, and marasmus is a disease which occur due to the deficiency of both protein and the carbohydrates. Look at this diagram. So this child is suffering from the marasmus disease, which is caused due to the deficiency of the protein and carbohydrate, because this child do not get the proper amount of the protein and carbohydrate, that's why his body become like this, and this disease is called marasmus disease. This is also an important fact, that is about the malnutrition. What is a malnutrition? It is a condition arising due to the inadequate or improper food and the unbalanced diet. Because it means if you get a deficiency of any food component, then it will called as malnutrition. Okay, at last we have a deficiency of the vitamins and the minerals. So if you have a deficiency of vitamins and minerals, for this we have a chart. So first we discuss the deficiency of the vitamins. So we have six main types of the vitamins. So first we have vitamin A. So in this chart we have studied the we have different columns, like first we have name of vitamin, next we have function of vitamin, next we have deficiency diseases caused by the vitamins, and next we have symptoms of these diseases, next we have the sources of the vitamins, that we have already studied in the previous topic. Okay, so first we have vitamin A. Vitamin A function already you know, it keeps our eyes and skin healthy. Its deficiency, so if you get improper or you can get the less amount of the vitamin A in your diet, it will cause the night blindness. What is night blindness? It is a disease in which person can't unable to see the object at the night. So this is called as the night blindness. It all
it also cause the loss of the vision, because it also cause the eyesight weakness in your eyes. Okay, so its symptoms are the loss of vision in the dark. So if you unable to see the anything in the dark, it means you are suffering from this disease, night blindness. So these are the symptoms of this deficiency of the vitamin A. So how you can get the how you can get rid of this disease? By taking which type of the sources? So these are the carrot, tomato, green leafy vegetable. These are very rich source of the vitamin A. If you getting these sources, you can't get the night blindness disease. Okay, next we have vitamin B. So vitamin B consists of vitamin B1 to B12 complex. Okay, so it is called as a B complex. But in this class or in this chapter, we will study only about the vitamin B1 and B12. Okay, so first we have B1. So B1 help in the energy release. It provides us energy. If there is a deficiency of vitamin B1, it will cause beriberi disease. Its symptoms are very little energy to work and muscles become weak. And its sources are cereal, peas, potato, yeast, etc. Okay, next we have B12. So the function of B12 is the formation of the blood, and its deficiency causes anemia. And its symptoms are blood is deficient in the RBCs, so skin looks pale and lack of the appetite. Okay, and their sources are meat, liver, yeast, milk, etc. Okay, clear? Next we have vitamin C. So vitamin C keeps the teeth, gums and bones very healthy. Okay, its deficiency causes scurvy disease, and its symptoms are swelling and bleeding of the gums and swelling of the joints. If you get swelling in your joints or you are bleeding, is came from your bleeding came from your gums, from the teeth. Okay, it means you are suffering from the deficiency of the vitamin C. Okay, so that disease is called as a scurvy disease. How you get rid from the scurvy? By taking the all the citrus fruit. Citrus fruit contain like lemon, oranges, tomato and the sprout. It means that fruit which are sour in taste. So all these are the sources of the vitamin C. Okay, next we have vitamin D. So the function of vitamin D is the formation of the strong bone. Its deficiency causes rickets. What are the symptoms of the rickets? There is a weak bone, teeth decaying, bow legs. What is bow leg? See this. This is a bow leg disease in which legs are bent like this. Okay, so how what are the sources of the vitamin D? Like the sunlight is a rich source of the vitamin D. If you sit in the sunlight for 15 to 20 minutes, then you will get a sufficient amount of the vitamin D. Okay, other sources are like milk, fish, eggs, etc. Okay, next we have vitamin K. So the function of vitamin K help in the clotting of blood. Okay, so clotting of blood affected if you have the deficiency of the vitamin K. Its symptoms are bleeding from the gums, and its sources are the spinax, cabbage, eggs and liver, etc. Okay, now we have the minerals, their function, deficiency, disease, symptoms and the sources. So first mineral is calcium. As we have already studied that calcium help in the formation of bones and the teeth. If the deficiency of the calcium, it will cause the disease that is called as a rickets, and its symptoms are brittle bones, means bones are cracking very easily, tooth decay, tooth become yellowish in color, excessive bleeding. If you get injury, lots of bleeding is occur here. So these are the symptoms of the deficiency of the calcium. Okay, and how you can get rid from the deficiency of the calcium? By taking the milk, cheese or the vegetables. Okay, next we have sodium and potassium. What are the function of sodium and potassium? Help in maintenance the body water balance. It means it help in maintaining our water balance in the body. So if there is a deficiency of sodium and potassium, our muscles and body become very weak and paralysis can occur. Okay, what is paralysis? In this disease, half portion of the person is get compressed, or you can say that they will stop working. Half part of the body, they will stop working. So this disease is called as a paralysis disease, and person can't get even stand up on her legs, on her or his legs. Okay, and what are the symptoms of this? Very weakness and dehydration, loss of the water, and its sources are salt and the most of the foods. Next we have phosphorus. So function of phosphorus is bone and teeth formation. Its deficiency causes same rickets in children, symptoms weakening of the bones and weakness, body weakness also. And its sources are bread, cheese, potato, etc. Next we have iron. It help in the formation of the red pigment hemoglobin, because hemoglobin provide red color to the blood. So iron help in the formation of the hemoglobin. Its deficiency cause anemia disease, and its symptoms are pale body color, whitish nail, body weakness. So these are the symptoms of the iron. Its sources are cereal, pulses or the vegetables. Next we have iodine. Its function, formation of the thyroid gland. What is thyroid gland? That help to maintain the thyroxine hormone in our body, because thyroxine hormone is a hormone which help in the growth of the body. If there is a deficiency of the thyroxine hormone, it means there is a deficiency of the iodine. If there is deficiency of the iodine, then it will cause a disease that is called goiter. Okay, what are the symptoms of the goiter? Enlargement of the thyroid gland in the neck, just like this. This is the swollen gland. So this disease is called as the goiter disease. And what are the sources of the iodine? Seafood and the iodized salt, that we have already studied. Okay, last one is a fluorine. It help in the formation of the teeth stronger. Its deficiency cause dental decay, and its symptoms are increased tooth decay, and its sources are also seafood and the tea. Okay, so now our chapter is completed. I hope you would like my video. Thank you.